The reason we don't need a federal ban is because the cities are free to ban it themselves. Beverly Hills has already done so. As of May 6th of this year, it was reported that city leaders and celebrity Phil Beverly Hills voted on Tuesday to ban fracking, becoming the first municipality in California to prohibit the controversial technique for extracting natural gas and oil from underground rock. So if cities can do it, I don't see why we can't have the federal government do it. Now let's get back to this issue of exemptions for diesel fuel. That actually is rooted in the original Safe Water Drinking Act of 1977, which set standards for drinking water quality and oversees the states, localities, and water suppliers who implement those standards. So that was in 1974. And in 2004, the EPA did a study on the evaluation of impacts to underground sources of drinking water by hydraulic fracking, and they came to the conclusion, quote, based on the information collected, the EPA has determined that the injection of hydraulic fracturing fuels into coal bed methane wells poses little or no threat to U.S. drinking waters. Continued investigation under this type of drilling is not warranted at the time. So even the EPA is saying that that companies should be able to be free to inject whatever chemicals they see fit and how to run their operation. Because from the EPA, which, and I'm talking about the EPA because they're proposing a separate agent, a new agency, so I'm asking, how is that agency going to show any different judgments than the EPA? It's just going to be sort of EPA 2 for fracking. As far as the competition between natural gas from gained from fracking compared to coal, according to Seamus McGraw in Popular Mechanics, he says that burning natural gas is cleaner than oil or gasoline, and it emits half as much carbon dioxide, less than one-third the nitrogen oxides, and 1% as much as sulfur oxides as coal combustion. But not all shale gas makes it to the fuel tank or power plant. The methane gas that escapes during the drilling process and later as the fuel is shipped via pipelines is a significant greenhouse gas. I'm conceding that, but I'm not conceding that is not something that could be solved. Obviously, they engineered fracking techniques. I think they can engineer proper sealing techniques if they chose to do so, or if the EPA chose to somehow compel them to do so. Also, concrete is not a suitable sealant for pipes, as it cracks easily, and certainly, given the fact that there is seismic activity, that right there is probably the first thing that should be changed. So that indicates that fracking itself is not flawed. It's certain aspects in how it is done, and that it can be improved. It is an imperfect system, but there's no alternative right now to the current demand energy needs of this country. Solar and wind energy are not going to do it. So you have to ask yourselves, if we don't frack, where is that energy going to come from? It's not going to come from solar, and it's not going to come from wind, at least not at this present time, and not for the foreseeable future.